Your doctor is recommending a cardiac stress test. Why does your doctor want a cardiac stress test? Your body needs nutrients and oxygen to function. Blood provides nutrients and oxygen as it flows through your body. When you exert yourself, your muscles need more nutrients and oxygen. This is provided by your heart pumping harder and faster. Several things determine your heart's ability to pump harder and faster. Because it is a muscle, your heart also needs nutrients and oxygen. This comes from blood flowing in the coronary arteries. Contraction is caused by an electrical impulse that starts in and then flows through the heart. Inside the heart, valves keep the blood flowing properly as the heart contracts. Stress testing your heart provides information about the coronary artery blood flow, strength of the heart's contractions, effectiveness of electrical impulses, and state of the heart's valves. How is a cardiac stress test done? Making the heart work harder, or stressing it, is the basis of stress testing. There are two ways to stress your heart: exercise or medication. Having you walk on a treadmill or ride a stationary bicycle is one way to stress your heart. You will need to exercise as long as possible to achieve a maximum heart rate for your age. If you can't exercise, a medication called dobutamine can be given through your IV to stress your heart. During a stress test, your heart is monitored with electrodes stuck on your skin. These record your heart's rate, rhythm, and electrical activity. This also shows how well the coronary arteries are providing blood to each part of the heart. An ultrasound or echocardiogram can be done with stress testing. This shows how well the heart is contracting and if the valves are working properly. All of this information helps your doctor determine your heart's health and the best treatment plan for you. Are there any risks from cardiac stress testing? You stress your heart daily, walking, climbing stairs, or with any exertion. If you have coronary artery, electrical conduction, or valve problems, your heart might not be able to keep up with the added work. This can cause anything from a feeling of weakness up to a dangerous heart attack. With a cardiac stress test, you similarly increase the work of your heart. If your heart isn't healthy and can't keep up, you could feel weak, short of breath, have palpitations, and even chest pain. Are there any complications that can occur from a cardiac stress test? If you exercise to stress your heart, it's unlikely, but you could overdo it. This could cause heart pains or angina. If dobutamine is used to stress your heart, you could have similar complications. Additionally, dobutamine could make you feel anxious, have a tingling sensation, or feel like your heart is racing. And any medication can cause allergic reactions. What precautions are taken during cardiac stress testing? Even stress at home could cause all of the same symptoms and be far more dangerous. During a cardiac stress test, the amount of strain on your heart is carefully controlled. Your heart is continuously monitored for any dangerous effect, and medical personnel are present to safely address and correct any problems. Still, it is critical that you tell the technician performing the test immediately if you experience any chest, arm, or jaw discomfort, shortness of breath, or feel faint or lightheaded. Are there any alternatives to a cardiac stress test? A cardiac stress test provides a great deal of information about many aspects of your heart's health. Other tests can be done to study the heart, but don't provide the same information. If you're worried about having a cardiac stress test, talk with your doctor about alternatives. Do you consent to having a cardiac stress test? While there are risks with cardiac stress testing, your doctor believes the need to obtain information about your heart outweighs the risks. Now that you understand why cardiac stress testing is done, how it will be done, and the possible risks and complications, your doctor needs your consent to proceed.